know music, to learn music for dance, and that is the very next session is composing music for dance. And we have two great legends who are going to talk about it and tell us about their experience and show. We have Dr. Padma Subrahmanyam and Professor C.V. Chandrasekhar. A very, very rare opportunity to know these insights from such great personalities in the field of Bharatanatyam. Arvind.
Julika Achar. Preeti Bharadwaj. Shubhada. Dr. Sahana. Shruti Rajalakshmi. Shilpa, thank you very much.
For dance, we are very fortunate to have two legends, and I will not take your time to. Composing music for dance. And I think the two legends that we are lucky to have need no introduction, Dr. Padma Subrahmanyam and Professor C.V. Chandrasekhar. And we are all eagerly waiting to see the making of their productions, and they have composed music for their own performances, for their students and for other artists. So it's very interesting to see the different dimensions in which they have composed, both for solo and for group. So without any delay, we start with Dr. Padma Subrahmanyam first, followed by C.V. sir. But most important, both of them will come together to take Q&A. So let's wait for until the end of the session and see both legends answering the questions. Thank you so much.
It's wonderful to see dance scholars, art critics, artists, jurors seekers this morning. Today is 2nd of Margari. I invoke the blessings of the Lord for the welfare of our nation. Margari is a month of prayer, and that's how we get together for our bhajana, for our dance. I'd be grateful if there is silence because I have a sore throat. I can't speak loudly. I would really appreciate your silence. The topic given to me and Chandru Anna is music for dance. A very important topic. I suppose you asked both of us to take up this topic because you expect some music from both of us. I cannot sing today. But I'll try to do justice. You have the word Sangeeta. And there is this concept of Taurya-Trikam. Sangeeta includes Geeta, Vadya and Ruttam. It has three elements. They come together and it is a sangamam of these three elements, and that's why you get the name Sangeeta. In fact, when there was a controversy, when our great Bala Saraswati was given Sangeeta Kalanidhi in Music Academy years ago, whether it was proper for a dancer to receive Sangeeta Kalanidhi. Dr. Raghavan argued, saying the same thing. Sangeeta includes all the three elements. I suppose there are many dancers and Natyacharyas who are really experts in music. They are musicians, music composers themselves. If you take history, you have the Tanjore Quartets, the great Nattavanars, who popularized the Margam format. The Margam format was there before them. Please understand, they did not invent that. But they were great music composers. They were all Shishyas of Muthuswami Dikshitar. And in fact, it was the Tanjore Quartets who introduced more ragas into the Marga system, because before them, if you see the Nirupanam, you have all the items, 18 numbers are there in Marathi, and all the 18 are in one raga. It is Eka Raga concept. So whole night there will be Kalyani, whole night there will be a performance in Bhairavi. This Margam format is already there in that Nirupanam. But what the Tanjore Quartets did was, if there was one piece in Kambodi, they had Bhairavi for Varnam and they introduced more ragas. Sorry, you have to put up with this bad throat. So, we owe to the Tanjore Quartet for the extraordinary musical variety that they gave. And one may ask, is it not possible to perform for Kritis? Why should you only dance for Padams and Padavarnams? The simple reason is that compositions meant for dance give more scope for abhinaya. Whereas in a kriti, sambodha hastatiye ethanadi kattinde irukka maakshi meenakshi idhe poite irukum panite irukum. Whereas you get more variety in the performance of pada artha abhinaya as well as vakya artha abhinaya. And we have to recognize the importance of musical compositions for dance, meant for dance. This is, again, something which we have inherited from the days of Natya Shastra, because the Natya Sangeetam that you have in Natya Shastra chapters is something amazing. You have the whole concept of Dhruva, Dhruva Gana. Different types of compositions are there. And it is from the word Dhruva that later Sangeeta operas, Nritya Natakas, derived the name Dharu. In South India, we have, like Padam, Dharu has a format. And there are many types of Dharu. Dharus are compositions which form part of a trance drama. It may or may not have a padam format. There may be a pallavi, anupallavi and charanam or charanams, or It can be Samashti Charanam also. But like Dhruvas, there are different types of Dharus. In a dance drama, you have the Pravesha Dharu. A character is introduced, and the characteristics of the character is introduced. It can be the heroine, the hero, the villain, the Rakshasa, anybody. It can be any important character, and the character is introduced. And there are jatis for that. There are special, there is Sheila, the handheld curtains used before the entry of the character. And this is very common for Bhagavata Mela, Puravanchinatakas, Tirukutu, because all these come from the same origin. It is all connected to Natyashastra. Natyashastra is the mother of all these forms from all over India and perhaps all over Asia. I would like to just show you the Pallavi of two or three Dharus. I'll take three Dharu from Viranimalai Kuravanji, who's a research product of my sister-in-law Shamila Balakrishnan. The importance of this Kuravanji is the original music was also learned by Shamila, and the original choreography to some extent I learned from the last Devadasi of Viralimalai temple. She was about 90 years old at that time. I have a photograph of her, Annamma. She was a fantastic singer. That's why I have to talk about her. And when she came to teach me, she performed the Pravesha Dharu for the Kurati, the Kuravanji. And she sang so beautifully and she managed to move at 90. But I was in my teens, I was gasping. I asked her, Pati, how can you perform, dance and sing? And for that she said, Neela roti tingra janmangal, nala paryadu tinnavo. That's the strength she was talking about. I will show you the entry of Parati. This is a Pravesha Dharu. It's in two talas. I will just take the first one, which is in Mishra Chakku. I want to show this because this is exactly the step that she taught me. And the nuance here is the way you use your neck. I'm doing something which Annamma Pati taught me. You saw how my neck was moving on the sides and how I pulled. This is something I learned from Annamma, but later found a name in Natyashastra. Then I want to show you the, this is Pravesha Dharu, but then the heroine, Rajamohini, has a beautiful Dharu in Kurinji Raga. Lovely Shringaram it has, and beautiful music.
Sakhiye naan mohamane sakhiye naan mohamane sakhiye naan mohamane ennai thaluvi avan sheerano sakhiye ennai thaluvi avan sheerano sakhiye sakhiye
did in our joint performance for collecting funds for Orissa Relief Fund. When all of us, Chandru and I was there, our dear Krishnavini danced. All of us were performing, and Dhananjayan and I did Chingan and Shingi. Of course, a lot of Manodharma was there on the stage. But I want to show you what a Uttara Pratyuttara Dharu is. It's a conversational Dharu. And you see how there is one rhythm for one character and another rhythm for the next character. I do both now because there is no time. Otherwise I would have drawn Dhananjayan on the stage. He would have forgotten these lines now. This is the Koravan Korati, the Shingan Shingi conversation. Shingan is looking at Korati. She has already got all the special awards, and she's decked with gold. She has jewels. She has already come there decked, and this fellow has his own doubts about her. So you see how the conversation goes. And the raga is a very rare raga. It is Saindavi. There are not many songs in Saindavi. And Saindavi, all of you would have been hearing in the wedding. As soon as the Tirumangalya Dharana is finished, the Nadaswaram, even today, will be playing
Anandam, Anandam, Anandame, Paramanandam, Anandam, Anandame. Anandam, Anandam, Anandame.
Actually, there is nothing more to this raga. It's a very limited scale, and you will see how this same tune has been used for the folk part of the Puravaji.
Hey, that is. Ye daidi vanji ye mohana mimani kuradi vane ni vittu pirindade ye daidi vanji ye mohana vina ni kuradi vane ni vittu pirindade naad kogal sukra Thank you.
ஒன்னா கேப்பான், பாதசரம் ஏது, ருட்டி எங்கேருந்து வந்தது, ஜிமிக்கு யாரு கொடுத்தா, இந்த மாதிரி வரும். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் உத்தர பிரத்யுத்தர தரும். ஸோ வி ஹாவ் த ட்ரெடிஷ்னல் மார்க்கம் and special music for that, and all these natya sangeetam meant for dance. In my compositions I adapted the format of Jatiswaram, composed my own Jatiswarams. Varnam, the Padavarnam format I used, and the first ever Hindi Padavarnam I composed using Meera Bhajan's lyrics. This is something I did 40 years ago, one of the things for which I was criticized. And then I did one Bengali Varnam, that was the first Varnam in Bengali. My first guru in music, Salil Chaudhary, composed lyrics for me and I composed music. Probably first time the great composer composed something for which music was done by somebody else. So I did a Bengali Varnam. I adapted a Kannada song of Purandara Dasa, Dasar Padam, to suit Varnam format. That was the first Kannada Padavarnam. That was also done about 30 years ago. And I had adapted Bharatiyar's lyrics, Kuil Pattu, that too about 30 years ago for Bharati's centenary year. And that was the first Varnam which was in conversational style. It was both Nayaka and Nayika talking to each other on their first meeting. And now recently, just last week, for Bharati birth, there was a celebration. I think it was 131st year. And I had composed a special Varnam, maybe the first of its kind for men to perform, because all Varnams are in the form of the Nayika or the Sakhi performing. Here, maybe you are a special person, so you could do it. Because you had to dance, you would have done it. So this is Kannamma and Kadali. I took Kannamma and Kadali songs and made a compilation and started with very, I would say, down-to-earth Shringara and slowly developed it from a physical to metaphysical level of Kannamma and Kadali. But this, I won't have time for all this to show you, but I must say that my inspiration is from tradition and also from composers around me, first one being Salil Chaudhary. Because even before I was a teenager, he was my first music guru. I used to sing Bengali songs. I used to sing the entire Chandalika, Shama, everything. And in fact, many of his compositions were done in our house, and those Bengali compositions were then taken to Bombay for Hindi films. Like for instance, O Sajna, the eternally beautiful song, and day before yesterday I heard Shreya Ghoshal singing Nisagama Pani Sarega. That was also a Bengali song that he composed in my house, because he was the All India Secretary of IPTA, Indian People's Theatre Association, and my father was president of IPTA. And they used to get together a lot, and we used to have a lot of music evenings. And we are talking about Jugalbandi today. It used to happen every day in our house with Dr. Balamurli Krishna singing, Salil Chaudhary, and G. Ramanathir, the great music director in films, and my mother, Meenakshi, with three harmoniums, Dr. Balamurli will be singing. And in fact, it was one of those occasions that when Dr. Balamurli sang Vatapi Ganapati in my house, he was very inspired. Salil Chaudhary made two wonderful songs, almost in the same tune. I wish I had better voice to give you at least one line demonstration. I would like to tell you that music is of two kinds, the kalpita and the kalpana. And I think dance also must give room for kalpana. I allow my musicians to play what they want, to sing what they want. They do never. And I keep performing. And there is some unison that takes place, perhaps because of a sense of music in me and sense of dance in them. It has to be both. Sometimes I feel even the mridangam has to be played according to the mood. For instance, you have a nice kshetre padam, a long drawn out beautiful padam, and when the mridangam starts with all the ferns under the sky, somehow it doesn't suit. I am a student of Vishwanathan. Dr. Vishwanathan was reader under whom I did my master's in music. I had been so fortunate to learn many padams from him in Dhanamma style. And he used to say, mridangam is also a pakka vadyam. So it has to be a pakka vadyam. And not, it should not drown the voice. It should not drown the mood. It should not drown the voice. For lack of time, I want to do just one piece. This is the end of my Meera Varnam. It is not rehearsed. Every time it is different. At the end of searching for Krishna, So at the end of the piece, I want Gayatri to sing the last part only once. Last part means just the last line once. And then I have tuned the varnam in Abhog. That is Abhogi of Karnataka music, Abhog of North. You go ahead. Patanjali, I give you all my best wishes. Go ahead.
Thank
playing
you.
What you want. And Kannan on the veena. Unrehearsed, you will have us.
दर्शन दीजो आए दर्शन दीजो आए दर्शन दीजो प्यारे दर्शन दीजो तुम बिन रहियो न जाए प्यारे दर्शन दर्शन दीजो तुम भी न रहियो न प्यारे प्यारे प्यारे
show just one or two pieces of you choose what you want to see. A bit of my choreography for Tchaikovsky. Or do you want to see one Angahara? Or you want to do Sukhalasam Inge Panirvan? I have to give time for Anna. Chandrona has to come. So you choose, maybe just you want to see Angahara. Just one. For this Angahara is a specified number of specified karanas which I reconstructed. 32 such Angaharas are described in the Natashastra, and you will see one Angahara here, and I have used the Sushkaksharas, that is the Jati or Bol, reconstructed from the Natashastra itself. I have used the bowls meant for what was called Tripushkaravadya. It used to be a three-faced drum, and so you will, when you hear the jatis, it will be a little exotic, but it is all taken out of Natashastra. It has been part of our 13-episode serial for Doordarshan, Bharatiya Natashastra. In fact, I made quite a few Lakshana Geetas, the Charis, the Nruttahastas, the Karanas. For all of these, I composed music. And the music and the moment goes so well with each other. So when the music is sung, the students will not forget the moment. Is Mahati working on the... I have finished. I'm just keeping them engaged. One karana, you will see how my music goes with the moment. Swastikarachit, Gayatri Padidu. You will see where you need longer note, where you need a shorter note, and I have tuned according to the necessity for the moment.
Swastikare chitam pani sani pama vesani. Swastikare chitam pani sani pama vesani.
So, is a Nritya Hasta called Avidya Vatra. Nritya Hasta oda varumbodhu, I tuned it differently. Just the 13 Nritya Hastas. Avidya Vatra.
Avidya Vatra.
So you see how music and movement go together. Now my students remember the movement when they hear the tune, they cannot do it differently. And this Abhidhavaktra, the commentary says, you have to perform this only in a particular speed, not in terrible speed, because it'll all be very crooked. So there is a definite pacing recommended for each movement. There are movements which have to be done in lightning speed. For example, the Vidyut Prantham, it's a lightning, so you have to do it in lightning speed. This is how I have synchronized music in movement. Loading mudi yenu. Sorry. Now you understand the concept of Sokalasya very easily. Now it's a total synchronization of music and movement. It's one of the Lasyangas of later, say 13th century period. This is documented in Ritratnavali and Sangeetha Ratnakara. But when I composed music and performed, choreographed, I didn't know about the name. I didn't know about the Lasyangas, because I had studied only the Natyashastra, and the Lasyangas of Natyashastra are completely different from the Lasyangas of the medieval age. Here, the music and movement synchronize so well that each pitch, each sthana, each swara, and each gamaka is synchronized in the body. According to the Vedic view, the body, the Upanishad says that the human body is a veena. So from this veena, we synchronize the swaras, the swarasthanas, and the subtle shrutis. I'll just give you half a minute demonstration of this.
Just three swaras have in todi have three sthanas in the body, pa, da, and ma. Pa, da, pa, ma. The rechakas in the body, from the foot to the head, depending on the swarasthanas. Ga, pada rechaka, kati rechaka, griva rechaka, and then the hands also. Ga ga ri ni ni da, ga ga ri ni ga ri ni ri ni da ni da.
Want to introduce my group, Mahati Kannan, Gayatri Kannan, Ramanan Amrutangam, Patanjali Flute, and Kannan. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Padma Subrahmanyam. It was wonderful. We'll have questions at the end after Prof. C.V.C. Chandrasekhar finishes. And Paduka, it was wonderful. Ninga kanna modittu Krishna ranga kondu vandel. Engalukku kanna chimitta kuda manasilla. Ninga kanna thanda avaru poiduvaru sonnal engalukku kanna chimittinona neengalum Krishnarum poiduvella engalukku thonithu. Thank you so much. We now request Professor C.V. Chandrasekhar to take the stage. We've had a wonderful experience trying to put this Nritya Samrachana together. We've been watching, observing classical dance for years, and we wanted the legends who are here with us to share with the next generation the nuances which they have learned from their generation and which they do on stage and can pass on to the next other generations, because we as such couldn't have seen the past. So it's a continuum which is coming down from them to us, and with so many jewels living in the city and nearby, we thought it would be the most appropriate time for people who come from outside and in Chennai, because even if it's a working day, for the season, people do take off from here and there and they come. I know it's very tight for everybody because you need to go from one place to the other, but it's always great. The season itself is a festival, and we request Professor C.V. Chandrasekhar to please come on the dais and start the next session. The questions or anything which you want them to share will be at the end of his session.